This is Chuck Carnevale. I'm the Chuck in the Markets Up, Chuck. And today's blog was titled Rim Reamed. And what I'm really talking about is Research in Motion announced earnings yesterday. And they're, you know, one of the leading, of course, they're the maker of the BlackBerry, one of the leading participators in the smartphone, you know, surging growth movement that's going on right now. And the company does have their own special niches. When you look at the chart of Rim, I want you to notice that the company's earnings growth has been, you know, really spectacular. I'm going to shorten this chart up a little bit. Here's a 12-year chart where they've averaged over 62.4% a year compounded, if you'll notice here. If I bring this down to a 7-year chart, however, I want you to notice that, you know, the earnings growth has actually been higher at 75.9. They have no debt on the balance sheet. They normally trade at around 40 times earnings. The stock price is down. You know, it's currently trading at around $70 a share, which would, you know, put it somewhere down about right here relative to this chart here. But the point I want to make is this. The company announced a quarter where their revenue was $3.5 billion, which is up over 37% over the prior quarter. This company is not losing money, not going out of business. They generated over a dollar, I think it was $1.03 worth of earnings. They did have a charge that brought that down a little bit, but it was a one-time charge. But their actual adjusted earnings were $1.03. They've got some great new products coming out in the fall, for coming into the Christmas season and into the wintertime here. The long-term forecast for growth for this company is over 20%. You can see here by the chart the forecast for next year is 19.5%. So almost any way you cut it, at the current valuation, it's currently at trading at around $70 a share. This stock is ridiculously underpriced. But here's the point I want to make, is that this stock was an $83 stock yesterday, and today they're pricing it at around 70. And, you know, the bottom line is it's a $47 billion company. They operate in over 170 countries worldwide. They have over almost 500 different carriers that, basically are offering BlackBerry products in these 170 countries. The growth of the smartphone market is going to be huge. BlackBerry is going to be a major participant. They do face a lot of competition, but to drop this stock 15% in one day makes absolutely no sense. There's no way the intrinsic value of this company could have changed that much in one day. You know, I can contrast this to some of their major competitors. For example, I can look at Apple Computer, which obviously is a formidable competitor. However, primarily in the consumer market, RIM does have several advantages over Apple. First of all, they're not limited to one carrier like Apple is, but Apple's a great company, and it's trading at almost 32 times blended earnings and probably 25 to 30 times forecast earnings or forward earnings, and RIM is trading at 15 times or below that. It just really doesn't make any sense. You know, the only other real major competitors out there would be names like Palm, and Palm is really a non-event in this industry. As you can see, their earnings have been almost nothing over the last 6 or 7 years. Nokia is a major player in the phone business, but they're still rather weak in the smartphone business. So when you get right down to it, it does come down to names like Apple and RIM that are going to be, I think, the major players in this market. Now, Google has the new Android product coming out. There is going to be a lot of competition, but when you add it all up, no possible way this company can be down 15% in my humble opinion in one day. This stock still has a lot of long-term growth and a lot of long-term benefit. It's a major overreaction in the market. That's opportunity knocking in our view if you're a long-term investor. If you're a day trader, obviously you were hurt if you bought it yesterday prior to the earnings amount. But if you're a long-term player, this would be even a great opportunity to pick up more shares. And this is Chuck Carnevale saying thanks for listening. As usual, it's Friday. It's the weekend. I'll be taking the weekend off. I look forward to talking again on Monday. Thanks for listening. Have a great weekend.